You're about to watch a clip from the Videomaker podcast. If you want to see the whole episode, click the link in the description. You know, regarding the recording logistics, this is really like a performance, right? You guys aren't necessarily just, playing games like people normally would. So how does that work while you're recording? Do you have someone who's literally like playing the role of director and, you know, as you're doing something, they'll make a decision like, okay, now let's go do this thing and we'll try to make something happen over here, or is it a really collective effort?
Yeah, usually whoever's running Spectator is the showrunner in a way. And they'll let us know, okay, I'll probably cut right here. You guys hold. We'll move on to this group. So whoever's running the Spectator cam is usually acting as the director.
Makes sense.
Mm-hmm. And you start out with like an organized, you know, I don't want to call it a script, but a kind of a script, like an outline of first we're going to go try this, and then when that's done, we're going to move on to this other thing. Or is it really more free flowing?
We just have goals. Okay, this is my goal for today is to tame this dinosaur. God, I feel weird saying that because I'm in my 40s.
I'm talking about
taming dinosaurs. But no, it's just a list of goals. And whatever happens within there is hopefully the magic that gets put into the videos. And sometimes you just don't have that great of a recording, which you rely on the editor to punch up a few things to make it better. But most of the time, there's never been a case where, I won't say never, but there's hardly ever a case where we record and it's like, we can't use this. Nothing happened. This was terrible.
Hmm. You guys don't, you're really an improv group is really mm-hmm. that plays video games. And so, but you guys didn't set off to be an improv group. So how's the process been at learning your roles? You know, did you all start with the yes and thing or, how do you guys play off? I mean, obviously you know each other well, but I'm sure that interaction has been something you've had to learn over time. Huh?
Actually, that's how it started. Everything that we've done has been improv. Going back to our animated series, Duralius and Associates, that was a animated series, kind of a parody of Dungeons and Dragons, Lord of the Rings. And we would have an outline and we would just go with it. There was no script. And we found that doing that, there's much more gold there with the interaction with our group. We know each other and we really knew our characters and how they would react to one another. And that sort of transgressed into the other shows that we've done. Battlefield Friends was the same thing. We never had a real script. We did a feature film where we just did an outline and just went with it. And we were able to cut it. It's messy a bit, but it works.
So you guys
it's just how we've been doing this from the beginning.
So then you'd be animating to the improv then, right? So the improv comes first and then the animation would come after that. That seems difficult.
Well, we'd get audio lock on something. So we'd have a bunch of takes of scenes and then we would cut it down to what we thought was tight and good, and then you animate to that. So you just cut it down to about a 5-minute video. It's, as long as you have like a good audio lock and you don't have to go back and do anything,
right?
Then it's pretty easy. Duralius and Associates, and I think Battlefield Friends as well, that was 2 weeks turnaround time for everything. So from the start of audio to animation all the way to a finished product. And that was a big credit to Brent Triplett or Neebs because he animated most of those. And I mean, it's just like 110 hours a week. He's a nightmare to deal with when he's animating, though. We never want him. We joke all the time. We never want him to animate again, even if it's a 10-second opener for a car commercial. I don't care. Like, I just want him to be happy.
Yeah, that's an intense turnaround. I can see why it took
that workflow was insane.
Yeah.
I mean, that's only a week longer than South Park. I mean, and South Park's got a huge machine with all sorts of money behind it, and you guys are doing it, and it'll probably be in topical as well, which is, that's pretty crazy.
Right? Yeah.